singing out love you, singing surpasses all understanding. It is mercy that keeps us here, Lord. When we talk about your goodness and your love, many don't understand it, Lord. But day in, day out, you continue to show us what your mercy means, Lord. It's a prayer, Lord, that this evening, even as we are gathered before you, Lord, you let your mercy rain one more time, Lord. You let your goodness abound one more time. So that we see from you, Lord, we hear from you, and we'll be filled with you, that our needs and our desires will be met. Thank you, Lord. We praise and glorify you. In the name of the Lord Jesus Christ, we have prayed. Amen.
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 Revelation 3:20. Behold, I stand at the door and knock. If any man hear my voice and open the door, I will come into him and will sup with him and he with me.
Amen.
Amen.
John Sashwe, meet you. Sashwe, meet you. E pronana na na me boom. Se ubi beti ye mene. The way he near Pono, Messiah,
Hallelujah,
Namino Abidity, now on them in so edity. Amen.
Praise the Lord. You may be seated. May the Lord add his blessing to the reading of the word. Amen.
Amen.
For a while now, we have been talking about I stand at the door and knock.
Amen.
In the meanwhile, as we sit here, we indulge everyone to be in prayer for the life of our dear sister Auntie Sewa, who is just here.
And
if there is any time that we need to be fervent in prayer for her, it is now.
Amen.
Amen. We've been looking at I stand at the door and knock.
Okay.
But this evening we want to continue on the same tangent. But we want to say the Lord Jesus Christ has been standing at our door and knocking for a long time. And we see it in scripture where in Revelation chapter 6, where the judgment of God was supposed to come on the earth. But the prophet said in the message, the seven seals, he said, we noticed that just before the just after the sixth seal, before the seventh seal was opened, there was an interval. After the sixth seal was opened, there was an interval. He says, now we want to notice this. It's very important that we notice this little time.
I say,
And this interval, the Lord Jesus Christ had to swoop in and do something miraculous
because
he has come to die to buy his bride already. And here the judgment of God was coming upon the earth. And now he couldn't sit still and watch his people go
out.
So he
has
raised from his majesty. Come down anyhow, start running at the door of every house and start banging on the door. It is recorded that he said, time is no more. That's why in the emergency of the night, the dark world that we are living in, he's going around banging on the door, trying to call you. So we see in chapter 7, he says, he wants the four angels holding the wings of the earth. See to it that you hurt not my children until I have finished sealing everyone. That should give you joy this evening. The devil cannot touch you until the Lord has finished what he's doing with you. Hallelujah. Then in chapter 8, he says, when he opened, before he opened the seven
seals,
he says there was silence in heaven. The king himself descended. And now what Abraham did for Lot, because you are also the royal seed of Abraham. Now the royal seed is also interceding for you and me. So if we see the Lord in this picture, he's doing everything to save you. And this evening, he said you have to let go. And let God. Hallelujah. Because he's embarking on a mission. And because he cannot fail, he has given the Holy Spirit. And the mission is a mission failure impossible. So far as he is there, there is no failure that can be
recorded.
Amen. Amen. Amen.
Ephesians chapter 3 verse 14
to 19.
Let go and let God. For this cause I bow my knee unto the Father of our Lord Jesus Christ, of whom the whole family in heaven and earth is named, that he will grant you according to the riches of his glory, to be strengthened with might by his spirit in the inner man, that Christ may dwell in your hearts by faith. So you see why he has been knocking all this while. That Christ may dwell in your heart by faith. That you be rooted and grounded in love may be able to comprehend all the saints. May be able to comprehend with all the saints. What is the breath? What is the breath? The length. The depth. And the height of the love of God. Amen. And to know the love of Christ, which passes knowledge, that you might be filled with all the fullness of God. Hallelujah. That you might be filled with all the fullness of God. All the fullness of God. God, you will receive the Holy Spirit. Hallelujah.
Amen.
Sometimes some of us misbehave in the house.
Out
of that misbehavior, our mothers get angry. And they can say things like, Jimmy, and those things. Let's be careful the things we say to our children. Hallelujah.
Amen.
We realize in Genesis chapter 41, when Jacob was about to die, he wanted to bless his children. So we want to look at four of these characters. He calls Judah. calls Judah.
Of right, Judah.
And he says, the scepter shall not depart from you, Judah.
Says, Judah, we ain't me free one chenko.
No, a lawgiver from between his feet.
Na embranim so free one nasi.
Until Shiloh comes, hallelujah. And we see that this happened in the life of Judah.
Yeah, we say we see what Judah brought.
And by grace, Jesus was born through that lineage.
Na, and I'm also
Naphtali, he said, you produce beautiful ways.
Naphtali, he said, ma aba efe.
He says, Zebulun shall ravine as a wolf.
Zebulun so be free mu aba.
Sorry, Zebulun shall dwell by the haven of the sea.
Zebulun so be nam.
He shall dwell by the seashore.
Obetina epo ano.
So we realize that when these prophecies came to fulfill in the life of Abraham, when they went to the promised land and they inherited their inheritance, Zebulun and Naphtali were together. That's why when Jesus came, most of his ministry was around Zebulun and Naphtali. Hallelujah. And because that was a prophecy on the life of those children.
Now
when he came to Benjamin,
Benjamin,
he said, you shall ravine as a wolf.
As a wolf, as a wolf.
As a wolf. A wolf. Sacrament. In the morning, he devises his
sacrament.
In the evening, he devises his plunder.
Now,
down through the lineage,
now, I want to
the children of Israel call for a king.
Yes, Israel man, no one hear or hear.
So God gave them Saul.
In the young people, the Saul.
In 1 Samuel 9:1, we read that now there was a man of the house of Benjamin.
Now, maybe we Benjamin fear.
The man was called Kish.
Now, your friend Kish.
And his son, and he had a son called Saul.
Now, our baby, our friend Saul.
And God gave him Saul to rule.
Now, young people, the Saul, my son.
When they needed someone to go and kill. When they needed someone to go and fight, they had to have someone who had that innate character. That's why God gave them
soul.
I don't forget every roof is
strong.
And because of that, pride enters soul. And he fell from the grace of God. And the lineage, the kingship went back to Judah. But through the ages, there comes another man called Saul. This time he was called Paul. Hallelujah. In Romans chapter 1:11, now Paul speaking, he says, now I am Paul.
As say that
and I have zeal more than anyone here.
Now, mention Obia or Wahibia.
Romans chapter 11:1.
Amen.
And I am Saul of Tarsus.
May I Saul? I mean, what Tarsus?
Hallelujah.
Amen.
Can you give me the scripture? I said that God has. Please go to verse 2 or 3. Good. I say then, has God cast away his people? God forbid. For I also am an Israelite. Of the seed of Abraham. Of the tribe of Benjamin. So we see that Paul is also of the tribe of Benjamin. No wonder he still had that ravenous nature in him. He still had the desire to kill. Although he had a zeal for God. So he went about killing the children of God. Thinking he was doing God a service. Hallelujah.
Amen.
Until one day, he met a certain man on the street. And the man knocked him down. And then he said, who are you, Lord?
Now, besides that,
the moment he addressed the man as Lord, at that instance, he was prepared to let go.
All
that he was. All that he knew. All that he had.
Let
God have his way.
Hallelujah.
And when he did that,
now yes, I know.
He took him to the wilderness. He lost all fellowship with man. He lost all his possessions. He lost all his knowledge. But he became a life of Christ. Hallelujah. Hey. And when he met the Lord, his life became a different man. This evening, we are saying you have to let go. And let God into your life. Maybe you are working with God. And you are not experiencing the wilderness experience. That is because maybe you have made God an acquaintance. He is just someone you know. He is just someone you heard of. And you think he has a good background. You think he has a good story. So it is proper to work with him. That's why you are not seeing any change in your life. But when you really meet him, and you truly work with him, and you allow him to walk through you, you allow him to walk in you, and he becomes a living being in you, I can tell you for sure, your face will change. I can assure you, your dressing will change. Even the way you eat will change. Hallelujah. Where you sleep will change. Hallelujah. So if you are sitting here this evening and you cannot examine yourself and tell yourself the things I used to do, I do them no more. The things I used to say, I say them no more. The things I used to see, I see them no more. If you are not giving those testimonies, then maybe Christ is your acquaintance. But I still want to assure you, he's still standing at your door and knocking. Hallelujah. There is still hope.
And that's what
if you only let go, and you let go, like we have been saying over and over here, there is no need to play church. Don't play church, my brother, my sister. Run away from religion. Let go of religion. In the message, straight is the gate.
And that's what we need to offer.
590301M.
Amen.
Paragraph 171, the prophet said, we all owe God something. We owe him our lives. Let's be honest about it. We walk out and say, sorry, don't say, well, look, I'm a Presbyterian. I'm a Methodist. I'm a Pentecostal. I'm a Church of God. I'm a Nazarene. I'm a Pilgrim Holiness. The prophet said, don't think that. There will be millions of those in hell. You see why it is wrong and totally hopeless to play church.
He says,
there will be millions of those in hell. You be a Christian.
Wow, we are Christian, you know.
Be in Christ.
It's like Christian.
Hallelujah.
Amen.
If you are in Christ,
so what Christian,
then you are assured of a future destination. This evening, let go of your life. What happened here this evening shows us that we live by grace. We walk by grace. We
take
only the mercy of God. You don't know when you be called. It's high time you make things right now. So that if he meets you suddenly, you are prepared to go. I know of somebody, my own sister, when she was going and they were calling her and we were praying, the prayer was effective. He brought her back. She said, why are you worrying me? Where I'm going? It's a good place. I've seen it. I want to be there. Let go of me and see the glory of the Lord. You have to be in that condition this evening. But when you are called, you can say, let me go.
This
life is fitting. Brother Abbe, he said, this place, we are like living on baller. Worms living on baller.
What I saw there,
tell me who
I don't even want to eat anymore. Allow me to go. I was giving grace to come and prepare myself so that I can go back there. My brother, my sister, we have to prepare ourselves now. What is it that you are holding dear? What is it that is so much of a privilege that you don't want to let go? In Matthew chapter 26, there is a story of a woman who went to Jesus when he had visited the house of Simon, and he was neglected because he was an acquaintance to Simon. But this woman, when she came in, despite her foul life, despite her difficulties, whatever she had made from the process of her work, she took it all, put it at the feet of Jesus, and laid down the crying, "Lord, I am not worthy. But have mercy upon me. Lord, I do not deserve it. But have mercy upon me." This evening, the question is, what is your alabaster box? What is your alabaster jar? What is it that you hold so dear? Is it that pride that no one talks when you talk? Is it that sickness that you have made it your personalized it? Is it that condition that you are not willing to go because you are getting comfortable in it? That you are made a grave and you are lying in it. You are made a bed and you are lying in it. And every time you come to preach to you, and we want it to you, you forget, you be so blinded that you forget, you know, that time is short. And that you need to repent. This evening, your alabaster jar could be some material possession. It could be some car you value so much. It could be something that you are making an idol instead of God. It could be your job that is giving you money, so you don't have time for God. It could even be your marriage that you love so much that you are displeasing God. What is it that is dear to you this evening? If this evening you can offer it as a sweet sacrifice to the Lord. That woman, when she was lying down there, the holy people around her, they despise her. They said, if he was a prophet, he would know their background. He would know that they don't deserve it. He would know that he doesn't have anointing. He would know that you are not worthy to come to God. But don't forget, while the holy people were condemning her and despising her and rejecting her, the Lord Jesus Christ was sitting down and enjoying her cry, even in her feet, even in her fallen estate, even in her condition. Whilst human beings rejected him, the Lord Jesus was accepting that sacrifice. This evening, he says, "Come unto me, all ye that labor and are heavy laden. Those who sins is so weighty on you, come and let us reason together. Though they may be as black, they may be as red, they may be as green, they may be as whatever. You just come. Come and lay it at my feet. Just cry it out. Just speak it out. I say, oh, to Jesus I surrender. Just give it out. And see the Lord take that smelly condition. See the Lord take that rejected condition. Turn it around and make a center of you. Hallelujah. What is your alabaster jar this evening? What is it that is so dear to you this evening that you are willing to let go? Is it your anger? Is it your strife? Is it your health? Is it your wealth? Is it your job? Let go. And let God. Hallelujah. In Mark chapter 5 verse 41,
In Mark 5:41, there is a story about Jesus going to the house, and a little girl was dead. And we heard people crying and say, it is all over. There is nothing that can be done. All hope is lost. Then we have Jesus coming in. He says, stop crying. This girl is not dead. She is asleep. And typical of human being. Anytime the word of the Lord comes, anytime the word of the Lord comes contrary to our understanding, we are quick to diffuse it and say, how can this be? As this is impossible. This is a situation that is not acceptable. As for this one, it's beyond repair. Now when Jesus comes to the scene, he will tell you it is not dead. It is asleep. So Jesus walks in and he says, Talita,
come. Sorry.
Talita, arise.
Talita, sorry.
Hallelujah. Amen. This evening, after you let go, and you let God have his way, and you confess to him, he's not going to leave you down there.
Wow.
Like the way human beings do. Human beings will stamp on you. They will make sure they bury you. They will make sure they push you further down. In psychology, we call them PhD people. They're pulling down people. They want to get ahead of you, so they pull you down. But any time you come at the feet of Jesus, it's either he asks you to rise up, as in the case of Talita, when he sees you don't have the strength to rise up, we have a God that stoops. He will go down and raise you up with him. Hallelujah.
Amen.
So when God asks you to rise up, when he asks you to let go, he will need to let go because he is faithful, because he is just. Hallelujah.
Amen.
And why will he ask you to let go? He only asks you to let go if he is capable. He can only ask you to leave your old condition if he is capable of giving you a better condition. So Proverbs chapter 3 verse 5 and 6, he says, trust in the Lord with all your heart and lean not on your own understanding. In all your ways acknowledge him, and he shall direct your power. My brother, my sister, you have to let go. There is nothing good in all these things. The only good thing is the Lord. Hallelujah.
Amen.
In Jeremiah chapter 29 verse 11, he calls you and he says, my dear daughter, my dear son, I know the plans I have for you. That says the Lord. And when you hear that says the Lord, he
means
it will surely come to pass. And the plans I have for you is good plans and not evil. And my plan is to bring you to an expected end, a future full of hope.
And that's why I said,
scripture tells us that when this corruptible, this one incorruptible, and when this mortal body, this one immortality,
then
shall bring to pass the saying, oh death, where is your victory? Oh grave, where is your victory? Oh death, where is your sting? So that which you fear most, the Lord is assuring you that your future is not death. Your future is eternal life. This is worth enough for you to lose everything. For you to let go of everything. We all have fears. There are various fears. We have fears of diagnosis. Some diagnosis that the doctor
might
give. Some of us, our fear is an empty bank account or an empty pocket. Is that not so?
Some of us, we have fear of a loved one who is sick, dying, or something. So we are always in fear, praying, Lord, have mercy. Some of us, our fear is being lonely. Some of us, our fear is being hungry. Some of us, our fear is maybe our car breaking down on the road somewhere. Some of us, our fear is fear of failure. We worry about so much. Sometimes our fear is even doubt. That what God has said about me, will he really come to Christ? Irrespective of the number of fears you have, there is another type of fear that I encourage you to have, and that is the fear of the Lord. Hallelujah. To fear the Lord is to love him and trust him, to know that he is an awesome God, and that the plans he has for you is good, and that whatever he says about you, he will bring it to pass. Hallelujah. Have no fears. Let go. And let God. So 1 Peter 5:7. He says, give all your worries and your cares to God. For he cares about you. The Lord cares about you. The Lord cares about you, my brother, my sister. Philippians chapter 4 verse 6. He says, be anxious about nothing, but pray about all things. In everything, with supplication and thanksgiving, let your request be made known unto your God. And the Lord of peace, whose peace surpasses all understanding, he will guard your heart, he will guard your mind. Hallelujah. For the Lord has not given us a spirit of fear, but of power, of love, and of a sound mind. So this year, let go. And let God. Whatever your worries are, amen. Hallelujah.
Amen.
Why do you have to strive with one another? Why do you have to try to be right all the time? Proverbs 18:3 says, it is to one's hand to avoid strife.
I say,
but every fool is quick to quarrel.
So
why do you want to fulfill scripture and be called a fool? Why
would
you just let go of that thing and be called a wise man by God? After all, Job chapter 14 verse 1. Man born of a woman is a few days, but full of trouble. One of the troubles is what we witness this evening. Our life is short. We don't have much to live for. We don't have much. Statistics shows that we barely have 3 years of our life to live.
Amen.
So I say, of the 70 years, of the 70 years, when you take the number of hours it takes for you to sleep, that's 1/3 gone. The time you spend to eat, study, to shit, and to socialize, when you do all those deductions, go to school, you are left with only 3 days that you live your life yourself. That is how short our life is. And within these 3 days, you are expected to search God. You are expected to find him. You are expected to know him. You are expected to live him. If not, your life here is worthless. If not, you are a candidate for firewood.
Say yes, sir.
So, Why choose to be a firewood? Why choose to be a part of Satan and his angels? Hell was not created for you and I. But Abraham says, I beg you. He used three adjectives. I urge you. Try your best. Everything you can do. Make sure you get the Holy Ghost. So that you can be in the kingdom of heaven. I would rather be a doormat in heaven than to be a prince in hell. This evening, that voice is still ringing. That why choose to be a log in hell when you can be a crown in heaven? Hallelujah. This evening, let go and let God. Let go and let God from the message stretches the gate. Paragraph 64. The hour is at hand. Every sensible person that's got reasoning knows that something is fixing to happen. There's not a person in this building that's got its right mind but knows that this world cannot stand under these circumstances. We can't stand, friends. There's not one thing. As your pastor and your brother, there is no one thing that I can guide you towards this evening. But to Jesus Christ. There isn't a thing I know of. Just think of the things that's prophesied to come here before the rapture takes place. This was way back in 1959. And the prophet said, everything that I know of is done fulfilled. You say, what about the mark of the beast? That's to come in the tribulation. He says, the church will be gone by then. We have to mark those. He's done gone. See, the marking is going on now. The marking is the showing forth. The brand. The character that you are beating. That is your mark. He says, flee to God. Flee to him quickly. I wonder this evening, while we are waiting here just a minute, I feel like you do. I can sense your feeling, each one of you, trying to think, oh God, search me out. That's the way I feel too. I realize this message like that, friend, is not popular among the people. You condemn them. You just make them low. He says, somebody has got to do that. I wish it had been maybe somebody else. But if you force my Lord to do it, if I have to be the scrub woman, let me scrub. David said, I'd rather be a doormat at the house of God than to dwell in the tent with sin. That's right, sir. Whatever God wants you to do, do it. Don't be ashamed. Hallelujah. So the prophet asked the question, how many will say that Abraham will remember me in prayer now?
Amen.
I want to raise up. So as we raise up,
you say, yes, sorry.
How many will want to be remembered in prayer now? He says, God bless you. God bless you. God bless you. So this evening, in as much as he's standing at your door and knocking, calling upon you, trying to tell you time is no more, run to the ark. Run to the place of safety. The only place of safety is the name of the Lord. Lord.
Jesus Christ.
The righteous run into it.
Well,
and they are saved. No accident.
I
claim you from there. No death. Can claim you from there. No disease. Can claim you from there. What shall we say then to these things? If God be for us, who can be against us? Shall pestilence, shall disease, shall persecution, what at all? The answer is nothing. So this evening, let go.
JBPM
and let God. Let go.
JBPM
and let God. Hallelujah.
Amen.
Take my precious Lord. Take my hand. Lead me on. Let me stand. I am tired. I am weak. Storm to the land, lead me through the night till my hands, precious Lord, lead me home when the darkness appears. Precious Lord, linger near where my time is sad and dark. In my pride, in my life, lead me on, let me stand. Take my hand, precious Lord, lead me home. Precious Lord, take my hand. Why don't you lift up your eyes and learn? I am tired of my sin.
I am tired
of my weight.
I am tired
of my circumstances.
I am tired
of my sicknesses. I am tired of my diseases. I am tired of my condition. I love this evening. Of my life, he will surely take your life and he will change your name from Saul and he will make you Paul. So why don't you pray to your maker this evening? As a precious Lord, take my hand and lead me home. For there is nothing in this life for me. Why don't you call on your maker this evening? Say, all to Jesus I surrender.
Yes, Lord. To the night, lead me on by the night. Take my hand, precious Lord.
Anyhow, Lord, Yeah.
My sister, the psalmist says you do not have long to wait. Scripture says time is no more.
Trying to say a brain whoop you.
Why don't you let go and let God?
Why
don't you let go and let God? Wouldn't you be happy for someone to look at you and see Christ manifested in you? Why do you want to continue glorifying the devil in your life? To the extent that when it is even being pointed out to you, you deny it. Why do you want to be a Pharisee where the Lord will look at you and say you are blind? You are hypocrite. The fact that you are living in Laodicea doesn't mean you have to be poor in spirit. Doesn't mean you have to be blind. It doesn't mean you have to be wretched. It doesn't mean you have to be naked to show how beautiful you are. No. You don't need to be naked, but you need to be clothed with the Holy Spirit. You need to be clothed with humility. You need to be clothed with the Spirit of God. Why don't you leave it all at the feet of Jesus once more? As we are for a word of prayer. Dear Lord Jesus, you've asked us to come unto you, and we believe in all sincerity that we have a desire in our hearts to come to you. And we thank you for your word which says, anyone who comes to me, you will in no wise cast out. How that the Father has given them to you, and no one can pluck them out of your hands. Lord Jesus, this evening we lay it all at your feet, Lord. Our filthy life, we lay it at your feet, Lord. Our filthy minds, we lay it at your feet, Lord. Our laziness, we lay it at your feet, Lord. Our prayerlessness, we lay it at your feet, Lord. Our hunger, our hatred, our malice, our strife, our contentions, our bitterness, our wickedness, our ungodliness, anything that does not glorify your name, we lay it at your feet, Lord. Lord, as we bow down at your feet, we await your command to ask us to rise up. We look to you to rise us out of our condition, Lord. Out of our weaknesses, Lord. Out of our sicknesses, out of our poverty, out of every condition that has not praised your name, Lord. Like you did to Peter, command us to come. And wherever we find ourselves wanting, we pray, increase our faith, Lord.
be merciful to us this evening. We realize this evening that our life is not our own. Any moment we can lose it. Even that, we pray for grace, Lord. Before we get to Jordan, let us have all the assurance. Let us have all the experience and the knowledge to know that you are there waiting to carry us across. We don't want to go unprepared. We don't want to leave this world on the evil side, Lord. That day we open our eyes and close our eyes and open our eyes, Lord. All that we want to hear is, come unto me, our faithful servant. That blessed of the Lord, come into the joy of the Lord. That is all we pray for, Lord. Therefore, baptize us once more this evening with your Holy Spirit. Fill us, Lord. Overflow on us, Lord. Until no evil be found in us. Until only your grace, your goodness, and your mercy be found in us. We ask this in the name of the Lord Jesus Christ, we have prayed. Amen.
Yeah.
poor heart with thy great love divine.
Feel my
poor
heart with thy great love divine.
Take all my will, my passion. Passion, self, and pride.
My passion, self, and pride.
I now surrender, Lord.
I now surrender.
In me abide. Holy Ghost, revive our kinds of thee. Oh, Holy Ghost,
revive us from thee.
Revive us, start a work in me. Declares thou supply my need.
Thou word
declares
thou wilt supply my need.
For blessing now, O Lord, I have a plead.
You had a message tonight.
I stand at the door and knock. Remember, as we're reminded, time is no more. Time is short. We are just living in borrowed time. Let's all commit ourselves to God's hands. The Lord help me. Lord, draw me to yourself, Father, and draw nearer to me as I surrender myself to you. Let's all pray. Time is no more. The coming Lord is at hand. You can be called home anytime, any moment. The Lord can also come anytime moment. That there's nothing more left for his coming. Everything can think of have been done. Sending down now, pulling us up now. That's what is left now. Let's commit ourselves to hands of God. Let's all pray. Help me, Lord.
Lord,
help me. I pray,
Father,
help me. Like the church, Father God. There's nothing left for that coming. Everything else, every prophecy you can think of, Father, has been fulfilled, dear God. Lord, bless you to me, Father. Lord, bless your people, Father. Lord, bless you to all of us, dear God. Lord, save us, Father. Lord, draw us unto yourself, Father. Lord, let the face shine upon us. Lord, bless you to us, Lord. Father, forgive our transgressions. Father, forgive our mistakes. Father, forgive our shortcomings, Father. May we realize, oh God, the nearness, that indeed your coming is at hand. Lord, may we stop fooling. May we stop playing church. May we stop being religious. Help us, O God. Fill us, O God, with the Holy Ghost. Fill us with the Holy Ghost, Father. That Father, we can reflect you, Father God. You are outside the door, walking out the door of our hearts, Father. May we open our hearts to you, dear God. That God, you will pour yourself into our hearts. Lord, you promise. I'll give you a new heart. I'll give you a new spirit. And I'll pour my own spirit to you, Lord. I pray, Father, Lord, honor that scripture in us. Lord, not my so called. And then I promise, Lord, give us new hearts, O God. Give us new spirit, O Lord. Pour your own spirit to us, Father. That can be a true reflection of Jesus Christ, our Master. O God, that may be glorified.
grant it, Father. In the name of Jesus Christ, Lord, we pray with thanksgiving. Amen. Listen, please listen carefully. I want to pray for the sick now. An accident occurred just this in around 5:30 right across the street. And involved 5 persons that were injured. Indeed, the 5 persons injured include our sister Sewa. But she was the most injured person among all those that were injured. She's really, really, really badly hurt. We need God's grace to save her. Listen, think of it. Put yourself in the shoes that if it were you, she had a head injury. Absolutely, the head injury, the car knocked her and dragged her about 40 feet in the gutter. Got a broken leg already. As we speak, the leg is broken. The last scene at the hospital was absolutely not something I don't want to talk about. Taking to the Wager Hospital, but she had to we need to ask God to come in. Only God can save her. So put yourself in her shoes.
Say,
if you are the one, what kind of pride you want to be prayed for? Was terribly bad. I don't talk about it. You need to pray for her. He's able to live a bona. He's able to deliver.
He's able to deliver. Keep it going.
You are sung by fire. There is no one like you.
Sent to hospital,
but no choir and Sabia.
And the doctors tried to stabilize her at the government hospital at Wager.
Now, I have here for no bomb. What you
so the boss says, I had to call a doctor, one of our brothers, Dr. Brown, to speak with him and see how best we can transfer her. Actually, the doctors were there, really wanted to transfer, so they said she needs to transfer, which I really understood the situation. And so we were trying to stabilize her. And then while they're preparing the documentation for transfer, I said that, okay, we are not getting ambulance. I called ambulance people. It was not going through. I was trying to communicate with the honorable MP, who was also a friend of us. And so later on, he went off. Actually, they were very busy in Parliament this night as well. And so calling the ambulance and not getting them, I said that, okay, why not? That was necessary. So we should bring the taxi to come and take care. Bring the taxi to come and take care. So I called Dr. Brown to really see what he could do for us. And he said the most important is establishing contact with Kolebu. That's the most important thing. So they need to do that while they are still working on her. So I said to go and get some bed sheets with the intention, okay, when it comes west, I'll just put her in my car, put her in the jeep, and take her to the hospital. So when I got the bed sheet all right, I got some policemen. I saw the policeman. I said, Mr. Police Officer, I have a patient here, and I want you to lead me to Kolebu, because just be just lead us, because it's a rush hour. We can't easily go through. So he agrees. Okay, he's waiting for about the junction, and then I came to the scene. As soon as I got to the scene, and there was our sister. Guess what? She was vomiting blood. It was such a horrible sight for me. And as I was spoken to the doctor, and that she needs to be stabilized, I realized that she's not, the stability still needs further more. I don't know what to say, but I'm not a doctor, but what I saw was terribly bad. Eventually, they decided to transfer and they put her in another car. I couldn't stand the scene. But brothers, sisters, you can be me, you can be you. So remember, life is short. Let go and let God lead. Let go of anything else. Don't let nothing be between you and your soul and the Savior. Life is so short. Time is no more. Let's as we heard the message last Sunday also, that we want to redeem the time. We want to spend our time more with God. We want to get closer to God than ever before. Let's forget about things of the world. Anything could happen to anybody, anytime. So let's remember again. Remember, she needs us. And she needs a prayer more than anything else. Not only her, four other people were injured. FO's driver, the FO, the one who has the big layer, the driver actually, he was badly injured as well. A child was all injured. Two other ladies were injured. They all been transferred to Kolebu. They all need our prayers. Let's remind them once again. As we call upon the name of our Lord God, only God can stand in for them.
Shall we pray?
Let's transfuse blood from Calvary unto them. Oh, shall we pray? Lord Jesus, we call upon thy name tonight. Be merciful to our dear sister Sewa. Lord, only you and you alone can save her. As your people, Father, we are calling upon your name, Father God, to intervene in her life. There go. Only you can save her, Lord. But Lord, we know thou our Savior. Thou art our healer. Dear God, everything, O God, to us. We have no one else than you, and you alone, Father. So, Father, be merciful to our sister. Lord, save her. Lord, deliver her. Lord, heal her. Lord, let your amazing grace come down, Father. We've seen you do more miracles than can you imagine. We've seen you done, Lord, amazing miracles. Remember, dear God, that Finnish boy, Lord God, that was knocked down by a vehicle and was dead, and you brought him back to life. That is the same God. The same yesterday, today, and forever. We want to remind you of the things you have done before. And we say, Lord, do same for our sister.
let the angels of mercy there call, oh God, Lord, minister unto her now. Lord, do something for her. Lord, see something for her now. Lord, save her, Lord. Lord, restore life in the name of Jesus Christ. Father, give her a second chance, oh God. Give her a second chance to me, Father. She needs you, Father God. Lord, grant it.
You send your word
in Jesus Christ's name.
And you heal my disease. I am the Lord. I
am. I want us to pray for our brother Edu Jemfi of New York. You, I didn't mean if you know him, he's been here, he's been coming to church anytime he comes from New York, he comes to visit us, he comes to preach for us actually. He's been also sick for some time and the doctors don't seem to really identify what the cause of
his illness
is. He's doing test upon test, x-rays upon x-rays and all the MRIs and
everything.
He don't seem to really be able to diagnose anything specific. So let's pray for our brother Edu Jemfi in New York. Shall we pray for our brother Edu Jemfi? As for my left, remember his wife also in Kumasi. My wife also has been hospitalized a few times this year. So let's remember him and the wife as well. Shall we pray? Father, Almighty God, lift up your God, your son, my brother Edu Jemfi. God, be merciful to him, dear God. Save him to Father God. May he perfect himself, Father, by all stress. Oh God, brother Edu Jemfi was healed in the name of Jesus Christ. And the wife also, Father, remember here, as well, Father God, you perfect the health also, dear Father, in the name of Jesus Christ. Jehovah, you are the one, you are the only one we have, oh God. That's why you are our God. We call upon them tonight, dear God, on behalf of our brother Edu Jemfi and the wife, dear God, that Jehovah, and please intervene their lives. And perfect as you promised that God, you will perfect the consensus. Dear God, be merciful to us. Merciful to them also, Father. Heal the sick amongst us too, dear God. Lord, let your mercy abide and abound. In the name of Jesus Christ, for thanksgiving. Amen. Because he lives.
Because he lives. I can face tomorrow because he lives. Oh, here is God because I know.
is good.
My greater still, the come assurance.
My greater still,
come assurance. This shall come face on certain days.
This shall come
on certain days. Because it is,
because it is.
Because
I can face tomorrow.
Because Christ lives.
Of the is gone. Because I know.
Let's lift our hands as the last prayer goes forth.
Yes, Lord.
Yes,
Father. Yes,
Father.
Yes, Lord.
Yes,
Lord. Yes, Lord. Yes, Lord. Yes, Lord. Yes, Lord. It's answered, Debia, that is here, Dawasi. Or how me a bedawasi? In Shremu a bedawasi. And Nijemu a bedawasi. I fear Simu a bedawasi. Your bedawasi, Dawasi, I said, I ran Sadda.
Yes,
never Dawasan, so I am Brahoda. It's answered, we are Yamia, when you call on Bahu. And then you measure Radua Boba and when I say, what they are some out to Yakuma Prince, Raduch no Ponachi, boom, let's see it. See what? Ube Ben no near Bididi. A Radiango was a Matia says, a black and you. Eradi fa usuro tu yakuma ponoso eradi fa ohoho no tu yakuma ponoso eradi fa adwuma tu yakuma ponoso eradi me yanaye ntentie wa wasore eradi me ye adipia ebe ye bia no enye wudie ni onyamhye ntina yeye yesose eradi anpa wodo ho ponpon so bedum ye adie nyara kire no na eradi anpa ya ye ohwim no kanfo bi na eradi anpa ohwim no anhwire yen yesose eradi anpa abre na abre na obekoso aboye ho ban esanse ye hu se e wadom no ehumo bono Bambos on your tears here. A younger see a papa ye be, a ye a number to be a yakin year to be, a ye homo by your wanting, a ye a papa ye be a yayin tear, that's what you say. No more, what don't know, homo bono, bambo, and in Shasron, what would you say? That's what you say. A castle radian papa, Jaya Yen and come for me and to men and me. Yet in Shayna Mount here, Rade, yet ya say a radum, a radian free and free when I see you. Yet that's what shall I say? Yet I see a woman, a radian hopa, what ya tadia at the tear and all my year. You are your fita. The one who I am a fita says you can't share about. Never I didn't go by name. One may I want empire to make a kaya home. One may I want there to make it to tier nine. One may I want there to make a cassa. One may I want empire and put 50 to me free. I am. Yakasi Dawasim. Yes, shouting can food it on tomb. And I didn't go by the SCN name. And I did a walk and I'll bet me a young baby. Yen himself. Well, I didn't go by Betty Babia Mats, Babia Sassa. The Babia, well, I didn't go by Babemu. Satia. Pam, and I say, Good
boy,
and I say, a womb by Benyanka.
There
were much to hear, there were more ration.
Yes,
some of my young people, Yamu, when you are, and I don't know yet. I have suffering now, Penny. Yet, young banning, I've won Nashaw and South. So I did be proud of the same Ponu, and I do best now. I saw my poor one, so that's all I wanted to mean. I call on so. So I know what was important, the one person part, and I can't open January. And I want my actors, yes, who let me ask, I'm afraid I'm a sorry. That's all friendly and now what the answer in part. Well, I know who put me up Bomwasi, you are the giant, I'm a yasin champion. Yes, sir, I can't look out. Yanis, I'm a man, and I'm Yanis, I'm a man. What's there? What's this about? Quan, I'm your new and I'm Nessia. Let's say you would dream and quala. Start your own hobby. It's an amazing sunset, and I say, oh, hey, and I didn't say what say, and I didn't know the Yamay. You're winning out also. Yes, sir, you're doing your own shame. You're doing trying to move your home. No, yes, sir, well, I can't go by and be Bibia Shaw and Sah, and I didn't know you couldn't deal.
Amen. He's able as to the offering to deliver.
He's able to deliver. He's able to deliver.
Today's Wednesday, Friday, that's one next. It's the first Friday of the month. So it's the first of the month, and as Man of Life is, we meet on the first Friday of the month.
We
should
be there
by 7 o'clock. So at 7:30 the song service can start. Please come and come all. Invite your friend to invite your friend.
I am running to some friend now before.
Let's keep start Sewa in our prayers and all the injured persons. Five in total, as far as I know. As far as I know. So let's keep remind all of them in prayer. Amen.
Amen.
There is power, wonder working power in the
God, would you bless you?
of the Lamb. There is power, power, wonder when he power in the precious blood of the Lamb. Oh, there is power, power, wonder when he power in the blood of the Lamb. There is power, power, wonder when he power in the precious blood of the Lamb. Oh, there is power, I'm